moving along with our next speaker, Dr. Sarah Whyte is a speaker, facilitator, and ICF credentialed coach. Dr. Sarah focuses on practical strategies to positively impact people's personal and emotional skills. She draws upon her years of experience in education and her academic credentials to support people and organizations in developing emotional intelligence. Dr. Sarah's talk, titled "The Emotional Equity at Work," will highlight the imbalance in how we expect men and women to express their emotions at work and the disparity in expectations that each gender faces when that happens. I can't promise you'll laugh or cry, but you will learn quite a fair bit from this next talk. So without further ado, let's hear from Dr. Sarah.
Imagine, it's Monday morning and you're leading your team and preparing for a meeting with your boss, but with an overwhelming sense of dread, because things are not going well on your project, and in fact, they haven't been going well for some time. In storms the boss, Sam, looking directly at you and demanding to know what's the update on that account. You muster up the courage to stammer, "It's already overdue, and that budget that we had to raise is going to have to go up again." In response to this, Sam is furious, unleashing a tirade the likes of which has never been seen in the office before. I won't go into details, as it was not appropriate for work, but suffice to say, there was yelling, there was name calling, there were hands slammed on the table. There were profanities that quite honestly would have made a sailor blush. By the way, did I mention that Sam's a woman? I say this as most of my audiences, when I tell that story, are picturing a man in their head. And this illustrates the imbalance in what we've been conditioned to expect in terms of emotional expression from men and from women at work. We're going to take a closer look at that now, particularly anger at work when it's expressed by a man or a woman, regardless of their individual rank or status. One research study highlighted three key findings. When women expressed anger at work, they were seen to be less competent, deserving of a lower salary, and having lower status. What's interesting and concerning is almost the exact opposite was true for men. Angry men at work were seen to be more competent. They were deserving of higher salaries, and they were seen as higher status. Now, this to me is the very definition of emotional inequity at work, where one gender is rewarded for expressing an emotion a certain way, while the other is punished for exactly the same thing. Now, as I reflect on emotional equity in the workplace, I know that most workplaces do not have in place to help what they need to help both genders succeed in the face of challenging emotions. And when I think about my daughter, currently still a bump, when she starts work, I know that true emotional equity is something that I'd love to, for her workplace to already have in place. How do we do that? How do we get there? Well, my advice to all of you, to my daughter's future employer, and to Sam's team, is to engage what I call the three C's. And these start with compassion. Imagine Sam's team talking about, you know, the meeting, and angry Sam is venting at them. If they can respond with compassion in the face of her anger, which I know is incredibly difficult to do, but if they can do that, they're coming from a place of kindness rather than judgment. The second step in this is curiosity. And it's important for Sam's team to start to question what might be behind Sam's anger and what might be causing that. That helps them to move from feeling defensive towards more empathy for Sam. And finally, the last step in the process is to think about communication. And this needs to focus on needs and values. Sam's needs and values, but also the needs and values of her team. So they can meet her needs, but also make their position clear. So through curiosity, compassion, and communication, that's how we can move towards emotional equity at work. For Sam's team, this means they can avoid making negative judgments about Sam purely on the basis She's a woman expressing anger at work. A word of warning though, this is not just a recipe for dealing with angry women at work. The three C's are equally important in any situation where there's a negative judgment about emotional expression purely based on gender. So for women, as we've seen, anger tends to result in that negative gender-specific judgment. For men, expressing feelings of sadness or vulnerability tends to also result in those negative gender-specific judgments. So remember, when you're faced with someone else expressing challenging feelings in future, compassion, curiosity, communication are the three C's which help us all move towards emotional equity in the workplace.